Squadron 42 seems to be wowing the internet as we speak. People who once cried scam are now bowing down at the altar of Chris Roberts. But do we need to be worried about Squadron 42's performance? Some of the frames in the 26-minute trailer were a bit suspect. I'm the only person on YouTube stupid enough to dedicate a channel purely to Star Citizen performance, so let me show you some of the worst parts of the demo. Let's count some frames, and then we can talk about why we probably don't need to be worried. CIG have been working hard on their engine. So let's start off looking at some clips. CIG released this video at 30 FPS, very cinematic, but we can't really read much past 30 FPS. We can't count any higher than that. And this is, let me be honest, a pretty dodgy way to count all this, but there are some easy things that we can see. Here's an example of a clip slowed down to 10% speed that's running around 30 FPS. So get that sort of frame rate in your mind. That's around 30 FPS. Here is a clip running at what I've calculated around the 21 FPS mark. Now, the frame pacing seems to be a bit wild in this one, but again, I wouldn't read too much into this because this isn't a particularly scientific way to do this. But you can see this is not running particularly well. This fly-through section looks really cool and will be fun to play, I'm sure, but I only counted 15 FPS on this one, and it's pretty clearly choppy even at full speed. And then we've got this space combat section they showed us. We have this explosion that causes quite a large hitch. This explosion frame stays on the screen for much longer than it should. If you play Star Citizen, this is nothing new to you. All of this stuff is quite normal. In certain parts of that game, stutters are pretty unavoidable. The frame rates in the cities can be very low unless you're running the latest CPUs from AMD or Intel. If you're new to this project, both games use the same codebase. So what we see in Star Citizen is a possible window into the future of Squadron's performance. SC for sure is very CPU bound in most parts of the games. I imagine this will improve for Squadron 42, but be warned, I think you'll want a good CPU. On the GPU side of things, a 4080 or 7900 XTX will get you at least around the 60 FPS mark at 4K in most parts of the persistent universe, but ray tracing is coming, and that will likely make Squadron 42 harder to run. For all the bad signs we see in the trailer and the live version of Star Citizen, I don't think there is any need to panic about Squadron 42. We've had quite a lot of good news at CitizenCon, the event that CIG does every year. This news hints that things are going in the right direction. Both Star Citizen and Squadron 42 run on what CIG are calling the StarEngine. It's got a long history, but basically it's a heavily modified version of the CryEngine. There is some very old code in there, but CIG have been working on some key areas that will impact performance. They've completely rewritten the StarEngine's renderer, this thing they're now calling the Gen 12 renderer, and they are working on implementing Vulkan to replace DX11 as the graphics API. They seem pretty confident about the performance Vulkan will bring. We'll have to see. They've also been working on upscaling, promising FSR2, DLSS2, and their own version, TRS. If you're not familiar, this allows a game to run at, say, 1440p, with the GPU performing like it would at 1440p, and then everything is upscaled to 4K. It doesn't look quite as good as normal 4K, but it's often pretty hard to tell. They also mentioned frame generation, and I think there's a good chance that that will find its way into Squadron 42. And although ray tracing will probably make things worse, let's quickly mention their plans for it. Over the recent months, they've been working on ray trace global illumination, which, whilst obviously in the early stages now, should push the game's lighting even further. These early examples show how properly bouncing light can really impact things. So, CIG are working on the engine, and as they enter the polishing stage, this is where any optimization should happen. The general way that game development works is that you get all your features done, and then you worry about performance. As Chris Roberts said, they haven't come this far just to throw it out the door unfinished. What sort of frame rate should we expect? Well, when talking about Star Citizen, many times the developers have mentioned targeting 60 FPS. My guess is that it will be the same for Squadron 42. I don't think targeting 30 FPS is really acceptable for a PC game. I'm sure some high-end PCs will be able to target high refresh rates, but for a single-player game, I don't think that's essential for most people. So yes, there are some performance issues in an early gameplay trailer, but that's all this is, an early gameplay trailer. They have work to do, but I'm not concerned about Squadron 42's performance at this stage.